The Green Revolution is one of the most important events of the 20th century, and it has led to many millions of people being fed when they otherwise would have starved or gone hungry. A green revolution refers most generally to an increase in the productivity of agriculture, but our green revolution starts with Norman Borlaug, an American who eventually won a Nobel Peace Prize. Borlaug was an American scientist, and in the mid-1940s, he found himself working in central Mexico as part of a Rockefeller Foundation program to improve crop yields. He came up with some major breakthroughs, including rust-resistant wheat crops, shuttle breeding programs to accelerate crop engineering, and stronger and higher-yielding wheat plants. Rather than just keeping this knowledge to himself, Borlaug tried to spread it to as many Mexican farmers as possible, and among the Mexican farmers he was known for his willingness to get his hands dirty and just go there out in the fields and work with them. Basically, these ideas worked. Borlaug is best thought of as a kind of genius offshoot innovator from a more general increase of agricultural productivity in the United States. For instance, between 1880 and 1940, agricultural productivity in the United States was going up by about 1% a year. That's okay, but after World War II, the trend rate of growth went up to about 2.8% a year. So this was a time when American agriculture itself was flourishing. This was due to more and better fertilizer, greater and better use of mechanized vehicles, better crops and hybrids, larger farms, and in general, the application of large-scale business and business management to growing food. Borlaug took some of these ideas, improved them, and adapted them for use to developing countries. In the early 1960s, the Green Revolution started to spread to South Asia, most notably India and Pakistan, and this was due in large part to the personal efforts of Norman Borlaug. During 1969 to 1970, 55% of the wheat hectares sown in Pakistan used Mexican or Mexican-derived varieties of wheat. In India, it was 35% of the wheat hectares sown. Domestic farmers in India and Pakistan were big advocates of this green revolution, and they did the rest of the work, and their political leaders allowed this change to happen. By 1970, the countries with significant increases in cereal production due to the green revolution were Afghanistan, Sri Lanka, then called Ceylon, Indonesia, Iran, Kenya, Morocco, Malaysia, Thailand, Tunisia, and Turkey. Later, in the 1970s, Borlaug encouraged the Chinese to move to a more productive variety of hybrid rice. Before the Green Revolution, it was a common prediction that the developing world was facing a future of mass starvation. In large part, this Green Revolution was not foreseen by commentators. Now it's the case that the world is feeding many more people than ever before. Yield rates on various crops rose dramatically. They rose for grains, they rose for cereals, they rose for rice, and they rose most of all for wheat by nearly a factor of fourfold. That's a comparison 1950 to 1998 for India, kilograms per hectare. The Green Revolution has been extremely impressive, and of course, much of the developing world picked up where Norman Borlaug left off. To read more on the Green Revolution, Google just Green Revolution, Norman Borlaug, Green Revolution India, Green Revolution Pakistan, and see also my book, An Economist Gets Lunch.